One of the biggest problems with the current consoles is that they come with slow hard drives. Microsoft recently released a slightly faster Xbox One Elite model, but we can do better. With the PS4, it's pretty straightforward to upgrade. The top glossy piece will pop right off, where you'll find a single screw holding in the standard 500GB hard drive. Once you slide it out, you just need to undo the four screws holding the drive in the cage and it's free. If you're upgrading your current PS4, you should make sure your saves are backed up before getting to the fun part, the SSD. A solid state drive is the key to supercharging your console with faster loading times, and the PS4 will support any 2.5-inch drive that's 9.5mm or thinner, which is basically every SSD ever. Slide it back in the drive tray, screw it in, and you're ready to go. Now you just need to reinstall the PS4's operating system, which you can download on Sony's site, and I'll have that linked in the description. Grab a USB flash drive and format it as FAT32. You'll need to create a folder on the drive called PS4, and then another folder inside that one named Update, both all in caps. Then drop the PS4 update file on the drive and let it copy. Plug the USB drive into the PS4 and hold the power button for at least 7 seconds to get it to reboot in safe mode. Select the Initialize and Reinstall Software option and give it a few minutes to get the SSD ready. After the normal PS4 setup, you'll have a fresh, brand new PS4 install with an SSD. While this is pretty easy to do on the PS4, it's dead simple on the Xbox. Instead of replacing the hard drive, the Xbox One supports running games off of a USB 3.0 drive as long as over 256GB. I'm using a Samsung T1, which is basically a full-speed SSD in a small enclosure. Plug it in and jump into the storage options inside settings. You'll have to format it to make it a dedicated drive for the Xbox, but after just a minute, it's ready to go. You can choose to install games either on the internal drive or SSD, along with moving games back and forth right from the apps menu. While the PS4 method is cool, it is so much easier to just plug a drive into the Xbox and it works. On top of that, you're still able to keep not only the internal hard drive, but also your SSD to give you extra storage. So let's take a look at the actual advantage of upgrading your console. Since the PS4 is 100% SSD based now, you'll see a slight improvement in boot times, but the main advantage is in games. On Battlefront, you'll see a small but noticeable improvement of about 8 seconds. An open world game like Grand Theft Auto 5 is even bigger, loading in 27 seconds on the SSD compared to 42 on the normal hard drive. Just Cause 3 sees the biggest gains, loading over twice as fast on the SSD compared to the hard drive. Jump over to the Xbox, and Just Cause shows an improvement with the SSD, but it's not as drastic at a little over 30 seconds. A less massive game like Forza 6 is only around 6 seconds quicker to load, but going back to a huge open world game like Fallout 4, again, the SSD is over twice as quick to load. While the stock hard drive is fine, and hybrid drives can get you a decent improvement, if you really want to go all out, a full SSD gives you the best performance. If you guys enjoyed and want to see more videos like this, definitely be sure to subscribe to the channel. Anyway guys, thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you in the next one. Microsoft recently released a slightly faster Xbox One Elite model with a bigger hybrid hard drive. You just ruined the illusion.